This conference will now be recorded.
Okay, so look at here. So this is report definition rule. A report definition rule can be used in order to interact with database tables and fetch the data from the tables. So it is going, it is similar to OBJ browser only. Okay, like fetching the data from the table. And similar to OBJ browser, when I see the results that you get by report definition will be read only or editable. So similar to internally, this form also executes OBJ browser. Ultimately, when you look into the ERPC design, internally, ultimately it is going to execute OBJ browse. It is going to browse the data from the table and make it available on clipboard somewhere. In which format? List format. List format, that is again like PX results what we have got. Here it is read-only data. When I run the report definition rule, the data has been fetched from the UI and it is also displayed in the fetch it from the table and it is displayed in the UI. This display is not there in activity OBJ browse. If you write activity OBJ browse, executed, content will be retrieved and placed on the clipboard. Display, you have to design by yourself generally. We will be working on that display design and all. But here, when you are using report definition rule, so by default, OTB, the display of data in table format is provided by Pega itself. This is one additional feature. Other than this, there are many other additional features available in report definition. Let me explain you about basics of report definition rule. In the report definition rule, you're going to use to interact with any table, fetch the data from the table. This, you display it or not, it depends on your business requirement. Ultimately, you're going to fetch the data from the table and hold it on the clipboard. Now, the first tab, what you see here is query tab. In the query tab, the first portion, the first section, this is select class properties. These are properties related to select class, select state code, state name, and so on. So something, why it not, I'll tell you why this is not displaying later. So select state code, state name from so and so table. So it is going to select and display the data in the UI. Everyone clear there with this? Now scroll down. So here you have where clause. Suppose you have where clause like where. Okay, let me check out this once just for testing purpose. Where state code, what is it, starts with something, starts with, what are the states we have got? T, we have two records, right? Starts with three. So if I am going to give something like this, where condition, just now you execute this. So you got only two records being displayed. Okay, so T and TS are starting with state code. Like this, if you want to write some where conditions, you can go ahead. So you have one, more than one property involved in where condition, you can go ahead and add more than one property in the where condition. And here you go where is equal to something. Between this where condition, you can write down the logical operation F1 and F2, F1 or F2. Generally in SQL queries, if you write where condition, where column 1 is equal to something and column 2 is equal to something, or column 3 is equal to something and column 4, something like logical operators you write, that you can define here. We'll be working on all this later. Now coming back to this one, this is the select clause where you're going to mention the data. Let me compare it with the activity which we have created. What is the activity name which we have created? Browse data states. Okay, now whenever you are using OBJ browse, you are giving the name of the table class. What is the purpose of providing the class name here? That means you are giving information to process commander from which table it has to fetch. Taking this class name, it will identify the table and fetch the data from the table. But in report definition, nowhere you are going to provide the name of the table. No parameter is there to accept the class name. Instead, report definition itself will be created in the same class from which you wanted to fetch. That means, let me tell you, my activity is there in which class? Data. I am fetching the data from which table? Data states. So activity is, rule is in some other class, fetching the data of some other class. This is possible in activity. What about report definition? Doesn't have any such parameter. So your report definition should be created within the same class from which you wanted to fetch the data. Suppose I want to fetch the data of states, then report definition should be created in states class. I want to fetch the data from cities, report definition should be created in cities table class. Ultimately, report definition must be created in table class. Suppose if I want to fetch work orbit data using report definition rule should be created in which class? Work class. framework related work objects I want to fetch. In which class I have to create report definition? Framework work class. If I want to fetch implementation related table data work objects, implement. So if you are writing report definition rule blindly, you can remember it has to be created in the table class from which you wanted to fetch the data. I want to fetch data from three tables. Then one of the class you have to create report definition rule. With the other you have to perform joins. Okay, we'll be working on joins sometime later, not now. Okay, this is for your information. Okay, so I am not going to talk about types of joins and all. This is too early for you to learn all these things. So report definition rule can be used to bring up the data from database tables, and it has also a feature of displaying in the UI. You can call this report definition rule in multiple different places. Let me give you that information as a simple idea. And here you go with chart tab. Suppose if you get the report definition data, by default it will display like a tabular format. This is called list format. Suppose I want to display like chart, then so you should have one summary. So you go to charts tab, you must have this report definition at least one aggregate column, then only it can be displayed like a chart. Without aggregate column you cannot display. So you can go ahead, let's say state code count something. Okay, now go to charts tab, you can include a chart. So now here you can display it like a pie chart, like this, like in a candle bars, or you can say like horizontal candle bars, or it is like a circle. Okay, like this you can go ahead and display a report definition, all these formats also, that is possible. Suppose if you go to any of the forms where analysis will be done, right, you'll see something like charts. Uttaradu kada,
yeah, it's
cricket chustaru kada. Okay, so that is the format. So if you want to display like this, you can use report definition rule. Using activity we cannot display like this, that is not possible simply. Okay, report definition you create this, you wanted to display it like a chart control, you just go ahead and make an aggregate column here, and then chart, choose what type of chart appearance that you want. You want this one, okay, like this, you select that and add the columns here, which column on x-axis, which column on y-axis. You just drag and drop, state code drag and drop here, state name drag and drop here, then when I run this, it has to display like chart format. Okay, so now here you go with report viewer. What is that? Okay, report viewer. So report viewer, I'll talk about it in few minutes. Now I've told you about data access tab, which can be used for joins purpose. So ultimately your report definition is going to fetch the data from the table, and you wanted to display in UI, you can display in UI in normal tabular format, or you can display in chart format. You created report definition, okay, then how business accesses this report definition rules? As a developer you are going to run this, right, actions and run, but business will not execute like this. Report definition can be used for different purposes, can be called at different places. For this theory you have to watch this video which I am going to share you. Complete theory is not there in the document, that's why I am recording this. Here you go with, now a report definition can be used as a source for a drop down control. Here you go with section, where is section? Section, and double click on this. Here report definition. So from which class you wanted to fetch the report, what is the report definition name, you have to provide here. This report definition is going to be executed when drop down is getting loaded. The results that have been retrieved by the report will get populated into drop down. I'll show you that configurations, will practically implement it in few minutes. This is one place report definition can be called from, can be called as a source for drop down. So now let me check out this, and here you go, advanced tab. So you go ahead with controls, like you have a chart control here. So just get a chart control added, drag and drop it. So the appearance of the chart control can be anything as of your wish, and your business is asking like candle bars, or it is asking like a circle and all, you can choose accordingly. Okay, so here you go with data source, report definition. You choose a single report definition. So you call the report definition rule here. Click the down arrow, you will see all available report definition. The one which you want, you can call it. I'll talk about the error message, don't bother about it. So report definition rule can be called as a source for drop down, and can be called from controls like chart control and all, if you want to display the results in UI like a chart format. These are two places. Other than this, there are few other places I'll tell you. So, and now if it is added as part of user interface, and this is there in section is there in flow action is there in flow, business users, they will run the flow. When they execute the flow, as part of the transactional processing, they will see this. Okay. Other than this, when business users are going to log in, let's say manager has logged in, this is manager related UI for your information. Here you have something called reports. Manager has access to access report definition rules. Now you go with user, just look at here, launch web interface user, case worker means he doesn't have a report viewer. Does he have report viewer? But manager role has access to reports. Okay, he can go to reports. He can find out all the reports, whichever the report he wanted to execute, he can execute and see that report definition. Look at here, just for your information. These are the reports which are available. If you wanted to access any report, he is going to choose it to get executed, like open. He will say open, it will be executed. All this is OTP available in Pega. Okay, your report definition which you are going to create by default will not be available in the report viewer. So in order to make that available in report viewer, you need to perform one step as a developer. Data access tab, I'm sorry, report viewer tab. Here you have an option, display in report browser. By default it is not selected. That means you create report, it will not be available in the report viewer there. So that managers will not be able to access. If I select this, it will ask me which category. Some categories of reports are there. Now you save this. When manager is going to, okay, I'll talk about the error message, you don't bother about it, try to listen. Now this report what we have, let me remove this summary and all. Where did I choose that? Okay, so now here you go with, so now this report definition rule is been selected with the option display in report browser. Now when manager login, what is the name of the report definition rule? Data table editor report. Maybe you can log off and log in back once. Application is not done. Generally, I'm showing you the manager portal also from developer login only, but I'll tell you how to create manager logins later. So here you go. When manager is going to log in, he will go to my reports. He knows that he want what report that he wanted to access today, and he wanted to see that report. All reports. Has it been changing the count or not? Count is not changed.
Not changed.
Did I check in that report definition rule?
Where are you checking the count, Harsha?
I'm sorry.
No, you didn't check
it. You didn't check.
Okay. Data access. Okay. Report viewer tab. This is where the checkbox I have selected. Let me save this and then check in this. It should be available even though. This is case manager, right? Reports, and you got it. So when you check in only, you're getting it. Okay, now yes. Here you go. Somewhere it should be available. This is the one which I have added. Now he can go ahead and run this report definition rule. This is for your information. So he can also change the parameter values here. So he can change, okay, he's going to remove this T, apply changes. Where state name is going to say, remove this, apply changes. So entire data is, he will be getting now. He wanted to add state code starts with something like T, apply changes, only that he is going to see. So he can see this report definition data from his portal itself, and he has additional features. What are those? You can see and tell me. The action drop down when I click, what are the features available? Export to PDF. When I say export to Excel, let's say when I see export to PDF, export to Excel, your server should have Microsoft Excel should be installed. Your server should have that PDF creator, it's not PDF reader, PDF creator to be, I think, available. Okay. So, okay, open with this one. So the data, what he's seeing in the UI is being exported to Excel. Okay. This is OTP feature. To implement all this in other programming languages, it will take a lot of time. So you wanted to implement a feature like get the data from the database, display in chart format, export to Excel, export to PDF, and sorting all this. It's like everything you have to code, it will take a lot of time, but everything, whatever I have told now, only you should know how to create report, what options to be chosen, what columns, that checkbox of report browser, and what is x-axis column, y-axis column, in which format you wanted to display. These are like a form based programming model. If you are going to learn this UI here, this UI and options, that means you are learning Python. But how to display, how to if business is asking, export Excel should be there. You don't need to think about writing the code for exporting to Excel. Other technologies, you have to write code for exporting to Excel and all. But here, export to Excel feature is ready-made available. So report definition has a lot of features over OBJ browser in the activity. But ultimately, report definition to fetch the data from the table also to use OBJ browser. Internally, OBJ browser, what is there? Here also same thing overall. But leave about that. Now here you go where a report definition is an OTP feature provided in Pega to interact with the database and to get the data from the database tables and display it to the end users with additional features of displaying like chart formats, tabular formats, and like sorting, everything will be available, exporting to Excel, exporting to PDF, like this. Features are ready-made available. Apart from this, I'll tell you some other concept. That is, okay, manager every day is going to execute this report, log in here, execute the report. Let's say we have created a report for leave request. Manager, every day whenever an employee is going to submit a leave request, the respective manager, when he log in, he will see the report of leave request. He will come here and he will execute. He will see all the leave requests. Instead of that, it's not about leave request, let's say approvals. So you are creating a case and there is an approval phase. Approval should be sent to, it's not even approval, I'm sorry. Okay, approval cases sent to manager, sent to someone, manager or someone. You created a report for all pending approvals. So every day there is a manager, let's say super manager, he wanted to see or monitor pending approvals by executing a report. When he executes the report, it will fetch all the work which has been pending for the approval from so and so department. He can change the department here and see something like that. You created a report, made it available here. He has to log in every day. He has to go here and click on open. Then he will see the data pending approval. Instead of this, business is asking, we do not want to log in and execute the reports. So every day morning 7 o'clock, report should be automatically executed by itself. Export Excel should be done automatically. It should be attached to email. Email should be sent to so and so person. When he opens his mailbox and download that Excel document or PDF document, he should see the data there simply. Okay. So to implement these features like this, in other programming language, you have to write a lot of coding. Okay. But in Pega, it is ready-made available. Look at here. So click on this. What is this gear icon? You have an option. What is this? Have you ever accessed scheduling tools, anything like meeting schedules or something? If you have access to that, you should know all this. Like one time only. One time only means only once it will be executed at the specified date, maybe time also. And here you go with recurrence. Recurrence means, so you can select the frequency. Daily, it has to be executed, or only weekly once. Let's say weekly, every Saturday, 7 a.m., I wanted to get some report on my email, something like that. Or monthly or yearly. Okay, you can choose accordingly the options. Starting from when you can choose, and no end date, or you can end it after some time. So like these options are available, and scroll down. So output file format that it is going to generate, is it PDF or Excel workbook? You can choose one of the option and send email notification to operator ID you give, and then following users from the operator rule form. Look at here. I will tell you complete details about this again while we are working with email integration. You have email address of operator. It is going to read the email address from here. Sender email where it will read from, I'll tell you later. No need to bother about it. I'm only talking about the feature which is available provided in Pega with a scheduler. This is called report scheduler. So as a developer, you should only know what options to choose here. That's it. Even you don't need to bother about it. Manager will select these options. You create report definition, select the option, make it available in report browser. It will be available to manager. For the first time, manager will log in. Select the report scheduling tool and schedule this report so that he will get the emails every day. Or maybe he will schedule it for someone else to get the emails. One or more operators. So like these OTP features provided by Pega BRPC in case when you go through report definition rule. Same if you want to do using activities, a lot of tasks that you have to implement, a lot of activity coding, I mean like steps that you have to write. But all this is already implemented in Pega and provided. When you are using report definition rule, advantages, I'll tell you. Suppose you create activity today to browse the data and you are making it available in dropdown. That is okay. Tomorrow business is asking same data, same activity what you have written, same data we wanted to be sent to email every day morning, let's say. Then what you have to do? You should drop up that activity and replace that with creating a report definition rule, report definition rule serves the purpose of drop down source, plus you can add scheduling for that additionally and export Excel and all. So now if you look at activity versus report definition rule in the requirement, in any requirement, so which one is better to create? Report definition features wise I'm talking about, technical I'll tell you later, not now. So report definition you create today, you are creating report definition rule just as a source for drop down. Okay, so this one can be done even by using activity, but you are creating report definition rule as a best practice. In future, if your requirements are changing to multi reuse this for multi purpose, then the features which are provided OTB by report definition rule can be utilized. Maybe you will get that requirement or may not be getting. Okay, you have to always think about, maybe if you get in future also, other developers should not face complexity in the design and development. That's how you have to always follow the best practices told by Pega. The best practice told by Pega is always try avoid creating activity whenever possible. Go ahead with alternate rules. At each different implementation, different alternate rules are available for activities, which I will tell you going forward. As of now, at a requirement given to fetch the data from the table and populate in the dropdown, we have multiple approaches. Out of which the two approaches we're going to talk about is activity with clipboard page, report definition. Over these two, what is the best practice is report definition. If I give you a requirement to fetch the data and populate in dropdown, you always have to give priority to create report definition rule instead of writing activity. Everyone clear? Now we have a question offline. What is the question? It is not an email, it is operator ID. Oh, click the down arrow. These are operator IDs, these are not emails. Operator ID is also in this format we created. Suppose you create operator ID like this. Okay, now in this operator ID, just look at here, it will read the email ID from here. This will be. Yeah, this is limited functionality. This one what you see here is limited functionality, adding each operator by operator. Okay, you cannot make it dynamic, that is not available. Okay, message also you can configure here, but the receivers, these are called receivers. Receivers are static plus limited. These are not direct email addresses, these are operator IDs. If you have more operator IDs, then you'll come to know generally. Okay, this is clear everyone. So like this, you have to provide here, this is a very limited.
Yeah, Harsha. So you said like whenever we get requirement to create dropdown, we should use report definition.
Yeah, blindly you can proceed to populate dropdown, always go ahead with report definition as a best practice and future ease of enhancements. Okay. Okay. So now here you go with anyone else has any. So let me repeat all this what we have discussed. Basically, report definition is a rule which can be used in order to fetch the data from a table, and also you can display it in tabular format or chart format, pie chart, something like that. Okay, this is one point. Report definition rule has to be created within the table class from which we are fetching the data from. Suppose you are fetching the data from more than one table, it has to be created in one of the classes. Other classes you have to perform joins. We'll be working on all of these joins going forward. It will take some time. Now first tab is query tab. In the query tab, you can mention the select class, and at edit columns and at the filters you can mention the columns related to where class. Okay, and here you go with chart tab. If you wanted to see the charts, you must have at least one aggregate column, then only you will see the charts. Without aggregate column, there is no meaning of displaying a chart format. You can display it like table format itself. And coming to the report viewer provides an option called display in report browser. By default, it is not selected. If you select this option, then this report will be available to access from the report browser. This is called as report browser. This is OTB available in Pega, which will be available to manager role generally. So from the report browser, managers or any operator who has access to this should be able to execute the reports, plus should be able to schedule the reports, should be able to modify the report also, even here temporary modification. Now if they click on open, it will be executed and data will be displayed. If they wanted to schedule it for automatically getting executed in the background, so they can go ahead and use the scheduler. So report definition has additional features of what are the additional features? Exporting to Excel workbook and exporting to PDF. So if you have any data which you wanted to export to Excel workbook and all, in the report definition rule, it provides the option of export to PDF and export to Excel, so that data will be exported to Excel and PDFs accordingly. You should have the respective editors installed on the target server. Same features can be automatically utilized when you go ahead with this one. What is that? Scheduler. In the scheduler, when the scheduler is being executed, report will be executed at the scheduled time. Also, the executed, the retrieved results can be written into PDF document or Excel workbook, and an email notification can be sent to the operators to their email addresses accordingly. These features are OTB. This is the purpose of report definition rule. Main purpose of report definition rule is for the purpose of reporting. Concept of reporting can be implemented in Pega by using report definition rule. Suppose if you have a Java application, you wanted to do reporting, you have to use third party tools, Crystal reports or maybe Cognos reports tool, some other reporting tools. If your application is .NET framework application, then you have to use Microsoft Business Intelligence, Microsoft Dynamics, like that. Some reporting tools provided by Microsoft like that you can use. But in Pega, reporting feature is included within PRPC environment itself, where you can go ahead and generate the reports by creating report definition rules. Apart from generating reports, this can be used as a source for drop-down control to display the data in a chart format using chart control. Tabular format also you can display in UI. Apart from this, there are other places also we can use it during the programming going forward in the business requirements. We'll come across with that. Everyone clear with this? As of now, we are going to work on report definition rule only as a source for the drop down to complete the third option. Clear? We have a question offline, just hang on. There are no specific dedicated reports which are assigned to him. All reports will be available. Means by privilege, it is not given. That is something different.
Harsha, operator ID should be always either case manager or case worker.
Operator ID
should be always either case manager or case worker.
No, I'll talk about portals later, only report definition. I'll talk about case manager, case worker, or analyst or support specialist. It can be any role. These are the filters.
Harsha, what is the maximum count to schedule, to send an emails for this?
That is not possible. Only we can dedicate reports to one person, or we can see all reports.
But when it came to practical
service, filtering only to him. Okay.
No.
Yeah, someone online, what is that? Can you please repeat?
As you said, is there any scheduled task that we want to send an email to the customer or to the internal manager? So what will be the maximum count like?
What will be the
maximum count?
See, if you want to send the data fetched from a table, exported in Excel or PDF to someone, then you can use scheduler, which will reduce your efforts, development efforts. This can be done manually also. We can create an activity, fetch the data, writing to Excel, and then sending it an email notification, attaching it to work object. That we can implement. During this time, it is static number of emails. The operator ID is what you give, maybe 10 or 15. I'm not pretty sure the maximum here. But in the activity, suppose you wanted to fetch the email address from a table, 100 email address, 1000 email address, maximum 10,000. 10,000 you fetch, 10,000 you can send if you wanted to send. So like that you can do. Okay, maximum OBJ browse is 10,000. And report definition by default will fetch top 500 records only. Data access tab, if you scroll down, you'll see that.
Okay.
Harsha, we have mostly DG groups created, right, to send out the report to multiple employees. So how that can be accomplished here?
It is like a bulk email, 1 million, 2 million. Approach is completely different. Okay, it's not like this. 1 million emails if you want to send, you need to use third-party email servers, integrate with Pega. That's how you have to do. Because 1 million, if you try to fetch here and then send it, system will hang.
Not 1 million, let's say if something like 50 to 100 users or something like that, under 100.
100 you can do within VRBC itself. 100,000 also, no worries, you can do within VRBC itself. We'll be working on this. Is not the concept of emails, leave about it. Try to understand only report definition. One feature is there. We'll talk about emails when we are working with outbound email integration and inbound email integrations.
Yeah, Arsha, I have one question from the yesterday's class. Since we are going away from this yesterday's class, I wanted to have that. I'm trying to edit the state property from the section, and when I wanted to remove the local list, and I wanted to have get the values from the state table. That's what I'm trying to do as a practically. When I open this section, I can see that. Save as actions are private edit. So do I need to do the private edit?
No. If you're seeing private edit, means the tool is there in locked version.
Okay.
When it is in locked version, what you have to do if you want to modify?
Yes.
You have to do save as. I've given that in the screenshots also. So always remember some rule is there in checked rule, locked rules at version, you have to save as and work on it. Private edit will give you only temporary edit. Which you can do test as a developer. Completed, discard that private edit. It will roll back to the original rule. If you try to check in that, it will show you new version to check in. You can check into new version.
I do the save as option, and then so there I need to give, okay. Then I need to go with the create and open. There I need to do the edit option.
Yes.
Right,
like same as the check-in. Yes. Okay.
Check out also.
Arsha, this is Ruben. Hello.
Yes, please proceed.
Arsha, just like scheduling, can we schedule auto upload to Cognos or any other process? Just like email.
Yeah, we have schedulers available. I'll talk about it. Working with report as job schedulers available. But as source of what? Draft.
I have one question.
Yes, please.
In the manager view, whatever the change, whatever the change in the filter condition, you said that it's a temporary change. So will it affect the where condition?
Report definition will not be affected. That is temporarily you are changing and seeing that.
Arsha, so when you are saying here as a drop down, means drop down that we can use in a UI.
Okay.
Is it the drop down that we can use in the UI or something, or only within the report?
Drop down means it is UI only. Other than UI, you will have anywhere else drop downs. It is UI only. Drop down means.
Okay.
Now, when you create a data type, PRPC has created class, properties, table, physical table, mapping between class and physical table. Apart from that, it has also created a default report definition rule by the name data table editor report. By the name, it says data table editor report. Table, if you want to edit, this is the report that will be used by process commander. Just go to the table, data types, states. So now, this is OTP design of Pega. In the OTP design of Pega, records are displayed, right? This is table data, right? Just hang on, let it get loaded. This is the data. Suppose if you change the report definition here, it will also get reflected here. Okay, so let me discard this. Something, did I modify or what? I saved as into version 2 and did any modification?
I think you have to remove the condition.
Where is it? Where condition? Okay. Yes. So let me check out this. I'll remove the conditions. It was not like this without conditions. Remove this. Save. Now check in this. You go back to the table. Reload this again. Now you got it. So maybe leave about these columns. Okay. Now look at here. This report definition rule, what we have there, created by process commander when you create a data type, same is used in UI here. This is the user interface. Suppose if I'm going to use live UI, just for your information, These are all properties, right? Where clause only? No, I have given another where condition property, some other value which is not there in the table. That's why it did not fetch. Now look at here, this report definition rule, data table editor report that is being passed in the UI, just for your information. That means the PRPC OOTP design, where it is displaying the records tab, this is a report definition rule. What is this report definition rule name? Data table editor report. That means you make modifications in this report, here the appearance will change. Data will not change in the backend. Anything you modify here in the data table editor report, then the appearance will change, because this is the same report definition rule getting displayed here. So generally, by default, when it creates data table editor report, if you want to implement any of the business requirement where you're using report definition on this table, generally we will create our own report definition rules. We will never touch editor report because it edits something here in PRPC environment. The same report is being used in records tab of data type. So we will not touch this report at all. We will create our own report. Now we are going to learn how to create our own report definition rule and make it as a source for the dropdown. Everyone clear with this? Write down business requirement.